Welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep, Terra's Route. And I'm not in any better mood because I'm recording this directly after the last video. So yeah. Ooh, look at him swim. Nice. Ha! There we go. So rather than going back there, we are going to... No! I press jump, you motherfucker! I hate Mermaid Lagoon so fucking much. There we go. Is this the way to Skull Rock? This better be the way to Skull Rock. And this looks like it's the way. This looks correct. So let's go slow. And send out at... I'm just having fun. For everyone watching this, who is your favorite out of these three main protagonists? I think for me it's Ventus, but I'm curious to see if anyone prefers Terra. I can't imagine anyone preferring Aqua over everyone, over the other two, but, you know, I could be wrong. And before anyone jumps on me, although I think they're less likely to jump on me because I am female, it's not a matter of... You know, the sexism of, oh, someone can't, you know, appreciate the female character. No, that's not my point. My point is that Aqua is poorly fucking written. It's annoying. And I, like, I just, and I don't really think that is anything indicative of the women aren't represented well in the video games. I think the creator of Kingdom Hearts, whose name is Terra, quite frankly, is just bad at writing female characters. Like, I think they all turn into either this kind of blank canvas or, like, the mom friend. Open. Open the Tizo. Ooh, I got another Firaga. Oh, wow, look at all that. Okay. Now we have another one of those, and I'm gonna have to make something there, and then we do have a Stopra, but most of our other stuff is actually kind of lacking, so let's see what we can do. Don't want another freeze rate. And that's not what I want either. Okay, so we're just gonna create our Kiraga. And Shimmering Crystal. And now we have to finish Kira. And then is there anything else that goes with? No, of course there isn't. Of course there isn't. So I guess we'll just do another Stopra. And then we'll make, was it Stopraga? Something like that. And then there's Kira, and we're good to go. I have to say, I don't know if I've mentioned this before in this Let's Play yet, but I like Terra's pants. They're nice and roomy, and they look fun to wear. Alright, why am I going that way? And I think they're Hakama pants, aren't they? So, once again, Terra has been used by the villain in the game, and rather than accepting responsibility that he's just fucking gullible and doesn't take 2 seconds to think about what he's doing, and just kind of accepts everything that is told to him without consideration of perspective or reality. He's gonna be like, I gave into the darkness. Oh, someone lied to me. Oh, me. And it's like, dude, just fucking think critically for a little bit, would you? So it looks like we're gonna go in a rowboat. I don't know where anything goes. Oh, look. Apparently we're going in the cave. Oh, oops. Okay, cutscene.
Well done.
Pardon me, Captain, but it's about that shooting star I was mentioning to ye.
Mr. Smee, I ordered you to drop that. I'll not have you gushing on about some shooting star.
But, Captain, most shooting stars twinkle for a bit and then they go out. But this one, it kept on sparkling and shining even after it crashed down. Why, what if it's really a big, enormous, priceless gemstone?
Idiot! Why didn't you tell me? We've a bit of business to attend to and must, I fear, step away. I trust you can see to things till I return.
Sure. When Peter Pan gets here, I'll be waiting.
Shh! That old codfish! Looks like he's found himself a new flunky. I'll fly down and distract him. Men, you move in and nab the treasure.
Are you Peter Pan?
That's me.
The light is not yours to take.
So, yeah. This is just... him. Look at this. Does this look like... I mean, granted, you can't always judge on looks or anything, but, I mean, come on. Come on. Here we go. And look, I mean, he's even affected by this stuff. I don't think any of the regular villains are typically that... this easily affected by all my stuff. Like, seriously. I mean, look at how easy he is to beat. I mean, even, I don't care what difficulty I'm on, he's not really fighting back. He's flying around. Okay, there. He got one fucking shot in. That's it. Look at how easy. Look at this. Really, look at this kid. And you don't even have to beat him.
What do you want with the light?
Light? What light?
Look, Pan! We've got the chest!
No! Not yet, you blockheads!
Hey!
Whoa! That hurt!
Oh, sorry!
Now what is this?
Pirate treasure, of course. Jewels, doubloons, you know, the usual stuff.
I've been guarding a pile of loot?
Sounds like you've been tricked.
I'll say. I owe you an apology. I picked a fight over nothing.
Aw, it was all in good fun. Not every day I get to fight such a good swordsman. Say, what's your name anyway?
Terra.
Right then, Terra. Which way did Hook go?
They said something about a shooting star.
Shooting star? Tinkerbell must be in danger! Men, guard that treasure with your lives!
Aye, aye, sir!
You go and get him, Pan!
Well, I should be on my way.
Well, at least least he had, you know, the courtesy of apologizing. But honestly, I think Terra's biggest issue is that... So it looks like we are gonna go save them, which I will do in a moment. But honestly, Terra's biggest issue is that anyone that has the slightest bit of authority, he just kind of accepts them at face value. Like, that's Terra's big issue. I don't know if even Ventus was that naive. No, Ventus wasn't even that naive. Like, he was... He at least understood when Ericus was like, oh yeah, I'm sorry Ben, but I'm gonna have to basically kill you. And he's like, well, fuck you then.
Unversed. Stay back.
Oh my gosh, I love this type of fight. I love this. I love the countless. I love the thousand heartless battle in Kingdom Hearts 2. I love this. Oh, fuck y'all. Look. Come on, this is so fun. Oh man, I love it. I love this. This is so much fun, I love it. Stop, everybody. Thunder. Thunder, bitches. Oh my gosh, I love it. Aw, damn it. Thunder. Oh man, I love the double ups. Oh, come on! There were still plenty left! I want to destroy them all! I must destroy them all.
Boy! You sure cut that monster down to size!
Shh. Ahoy! How fare ye, lad?
Hook!
Go hide.
Fine. All's well.
What's that?
Tinkerbell, one of Peter Pan's dearest friends.
Can I take a look?
So long as I have his precious pixie, Pan's demise is all but assured. What's the meaning of this?
You know, I didn't give it that much thought. Just doing what my heart tells me.
That's mutiny! And you'll walk the plank for it! That sound!
Hooray! We sure showed Hook this time!
Every star up there is another world.
Huh? Terra.
Yep. Hard to believe there are so many worlds out there besides our own. The light is their hearts. And it's shining down on us like a million lanterns.
What? I don't get it.
In other words, they're just like you, Ven.
What does that mean?
You'll find out someday, I'm sure.
I want to know now.
Oh, so much for the pirate treasures.
Hmm.
Did you guys really want the jewels and gold that badly?
Huh? Nah, we don't care about that stuff.
Pan was counting on us.
I'll tell you what. Put the stuff that's really special to you in there. That can be your treasure.
Yeah! Real swell idea! Thanks!
Kinda makes me wonder what I'd put in there.
Somewhere out there, there's this tree with star-shaped fruit.
Then, I wonder if we'll ever be a team again. Looks like all the things that once held us together just push us further away. And now the light has led me here. What am I supposed to do? Was I guided here in order to meet that boy?
Oh! Ahoy! We're over here! Riku, race ya! First one to the boat gets to be captain! Come on! You call that running?
World?
Huh? Why would you say that?
Because nobody lives out here. And I know you're not from the main island.
Smart kid. So how about you? What are you doing here?
Oh. My friend's dad took us out on the boat. This is where we like to play. But it won't let us row out here by ourselves. Not till we get older.
Must be hard, huh? Stuck in one place.
Kid left for good. So how did you get here anyway?
Is there some reason you're interested in the outside world?
Yeah. I want to be strong one day. Like that kid who left. He went to the outside world. Betty's really strong now. I know it's out there somewhere, the strength that I need.
Strength for what?
To protect the things that matter. You know, like my friends.
Outside this tiny world is a much bigger one. In your hand, take this key. So long as you have the makings, then through this simple act of taking, its wielder you shall one day be, and you will find me, friend. No ocean will contain you then. No more borders around or below or above, so long as you champion the ones you love. Gotta keep this a secret, okay? Otherwise, all the magic will wear off.
Hey, what was that all about?
You know.
Know what? Why won't you tell me? Who was that guy? Somebody you know?
Maybe.
Oh, there you go again. Just tell me.
I really can't. I've gotta keep it a secret.
Not with me, you don't. I'm like the best secret keeper in the world.
Nice try.
Oh, Riku!
Protect the things that matter. Right. My friends matter to me, too. So, I still have things that I have to protect.
That light. Is it Ben?
Master Terra, find me. We must speak at once.
Master Xehanort.
So that ran a little longer than I thought it would, so I'm going to end the part here, and I will give you my thoughts in the next part. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.